प्रमुख निर्णायक ज्यू बाहेक अन्य 10 जना निर्णायक ज्यूहरुले प्रश्न सोध्नु हुनेछ प्रत्येक कन्टेस्टेन्टलाई प्रत्येक प्रश्न आउनेछ र त्यही प्रश्नको उत्तरको आधारमा टप 5 मा को पुग्नु हुन्छ निर्धारण हुन्छ त्यसैले यो राउन्डमा कन्टेस्टेन्ट्सहरुले यानी कि टप 10 सेमी फाइनलिस्टहरुले आफ्नो भाग्य आफ्नै हातमा बोक्नु भएको हुन्छ तर अहिले उहाँहरुको भाग्य मेरो हातमा छ भन्नुको मतलब जजेसहरुको नाम मसँग छ सेमी फाइनलिस्ट अगाडि आउनु हुनेछ आफ्नो लागि जज पिक गर्नु हुनेछ अनि आन्सर दिनु हुनेछ निम्ति आउन चाहन्छ पहिलो सेमी फाइनलिस्टलाई वाउ एकदमै राम्रो देखिनु भएको छ आफ्नो लागि जज पिक गर्नुस् उहाँले चुज गर्नुभएको छ मिस्टर शक्ति बेगाली
हेलो
हेलो सर
गुड इभिनिङ सदीक्षा हाउ आर यू
आई एम डूइंग गुड
यू आर लुकिंग गॉर्जियस
थैंक यू सो मच
ओके सदीक्षा माय क्वेश्चन इज इट इज ऑलवेज सेड दैट बिहाइंड एवरी सक्सेसफुल मैन देयर इज अ वुमन बट व्हाई इज इट नेवर सेड That behind every successful woman, there is a man. I'll translate in Hindi, Nepali also?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, to bhanai chha ki, harek safal purush ko pachhadi, mahila ko haath huncha. Tara, harek safal mahila ko pachhadi, purush ko haath huncha bhanera, kina bhanindaina. Yesma tapai ko ke vichar chha. Thank you.
Well, in my opinion, yes, definitely. Behind every successful man, there is a woman. Be it in the form of his mother, his grandmother, his wife, or his daughter. And I also believe in the statement that behind every successful woman, there is a man. It is just that the saying is a little less popular. But I do believe that men and women can go hand in hand and make each other successful. Thank you.
Thanks, Adiksha. Thank you
very much, Adiksha. Thank you. र उहाँको आन्सर धेरैलाई मन परेको छ र यो आन्सरले उहाँलाई टप 5 मा पुर्याउने हो अथवा होइन अहिलेसम्म हामीलाई थाहा छैन नेक्स्ट कन्टेस्टेन्ट नेक्स्ट सेमी फाइनलिस्ट जज स्पिक गर्नु होला उहाँले पिक गर्नुभएको छ मिस्टर सुभाष निरौला
Rita,
yes sir.
How are you today?
I'm doing good, sir.
I'm nervous, don't you think?
Fine, sir.
Yeah. Well, as usual, I think as a tourism man, I have a very interesting question for you.
Okay, sir.
I'll tell you both in English and Nepali.
Yes, sir.
My question is, if you are appointed as a goodwill ambassador of Nepal Tourism Year 2011, how will you promote your country? As a must-visit tourist destination in the world. I repeat, if you are appointed as a Goodwill Ambassador of Nepal Tourism Year 2011, how will you promote your country as a must-visit tourist destination in the world? Nepali ma, tapai Nepal Paryatan Barsh 2011 ko Sadbhavana Dut niyukt hunu bhayo bhane, Nepal lai bhraman garnai parne paryatakiya gantabya ko roop ma vishwa samu kasari prawardhan garnuhuncha.
Okay? Yes,
question
sir.
Starts.
Thank you for the question, sir. Before moving on with the topic of attracting tourists, what I'd like to say is, firstly, we must have economic competitiveness in our society. We must first build our economy strong by investing in our natural resources, utilizing our resources, and investing in national infrastructure. Then only we can develop hotels and motels. Then secondly, we must encourage people to save our culture and promote them internationally and nationally. Then only we can say that, yes, we can attract national and international tourists. And yes, if I am supposed to be the ambassador of year 2011 of tourism year, the first thing I would do is encourage people to be a part of promotion for peace, non-violence and reconciliation. And then I would aware all of the people to attract domestic as well as foreign tourists to visit Nepal to see the natural beauty of Nepal. That way our economy will be competitive enough and can share the power among the world. Thank you. धेरै रिजनहरु वहाले भन्नुभयो धेरै धेरै धन्यवाद छ अब हामी निम्त्याउन चाहन्छौ थर्ड सेमी फाइनलिस्टलाई अब आफ्नो भाग्य पिक गर्नुस् She has chosen Mrs. Bhavani Rana.
You're looking very beautiful, Sadhana.
Thank you, ma'am. So are you.
Thank you. So my question is, in the present context of Nepal, what do you think is more important concerning issue of women empowerment, political agenda or economic agenda? Please explain why do you think so? I'll repeat in Nepali if you want. Should I?
Yes, please.
हाल नेपालको सन्दर्भमा महिला सशक्तिकरण बारेमा कुरा गर्दा कुन विषयवस्तु बढी महत्त्वपूर्ण भन्ने ठान्नु भएको छ? राजनीतिक मुद्दा या आर्थिक मुद्दा? र किन यस्तो ठान्नुहुन्छ?
In my opinion, today's context, political sector is more important for the empowerment of women. Because politics is very powerful and politics is the only sector which can bring change and which can, yes, of course, empower women. And apart from that, our perception towards women, which we consider as weaker sex, should also be ignored. Yes, thank you so much.
Thank you, Sahana. मैले एकदम आफ्नो टाइम सम्झिरहेको छु ठुकठुकी बढी बढिरहेको छ र फर्म सुभाषहरूलाई पनि देखिरहेको छु उहाँलाई पनि सायद त्यही भइरहेको होला अर्को सेमी फाइनलिस्ट चुज गर्नुहोस् जज उहाँले पिक गर्नुभएको छ निशा अधिकारी
गुड इभिनिङ आर यू नर्भस
China.
Please don't be. Here's the question. Please be ready for it. Death penalty is still conducted in many parts of the world. Do you think it should be banned? If yes, why? If not, why not?
Nepali ma bhanna chahanchu. Vishwa ka pray muluk ma ajai pani mrityu danda dine kanuni prachalan chha. Ke yahan lai yasma pratibandha lagainu parcha jasto lagcha? पर्छ भने किन पर्दैन भने किन पर्दैन
मेरो विचारमा मृत्युदण्ड एकैचोटिमा मृत्युदण्ड दिनु राम्रो होइन किनभने यदि एकैचोटिमा हामीले मृत्युदण्ड दियौँ भने उनीहरूलाई आफूले गरेको गल्ती सच्याउनको लागि समय मिल्दैन यदि मृत्युदण्ड नदिएर अरू ठोस सजाय दिने हो भने उनीहरूलाई आफूले गरेको गल्तीप्रति पछुतो हुन्छ र भोलिको पिँढीहरूमा उनीहरूले यो गल्ती नदोहोर्याउन पनि सक्छन् धन्यवाद
थ्याङ्क यू आरती अब यो आन्सरले उहाँलाई टप फाइभमा पुर्याउने हो अथवा होइन अहिलेसम्म थाहा छैन अर्को सेमी फाइनलिस्ट मेरो नजिक आउँदै हुनुहुन्छ She has chosen Charu Chadda.
Hi, how are you?
I am doing good, ma'am.
Great. You ready for the question?
Yes, sort of.
Great. If God were to grant you immortality, would you accept? If yes, why? If not, why?
If God were to grant me immortality, I believe I would not accept it. Because life is beautiful only because there is death in the end. And if there were no death, then people would not cherish their life and learn to enjoy the moments. So I would not accept mortality. I'd rather be like any other human being. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Samruddhi. अहिले सम्ममा पाँचजना सेमी फाइनलिस्टको क्वेसन एन्ड आन्सर हामीले सुनिसकेका छौँ अब पाँचजना अन्य सेमी फाइनलिस्टको कार्यक्रम अगाडि बढाउन को होस्ट सुमित इज अलरेडी हियर
थ्याङ्क यू भेरी मच शिखरिका फाइभ डाउन एन्ड फाइभ मोर टु गो शिखरिका क्यान आई प्लिज हेभ द नेम अफ द जजेस विदाउट द्याट इट्स सो गना बी इम्पोसिबल सो वी हेभ आवर नेक्स्ट सेमी फाइनलिस्ट सो कुसुम प्लिज choose the judge and she has chosen Mr. Bhaskar Raj Rajkarnikar.
Kusumanjali.
Yes, sir.
Shubha Sandhya.
Shubha Sandhya, sir.
प्रश्नले गहिरो ढङ्गबाट सुन्नुहोस् है म अलि तपाईँ मैले सोधेको प्रश्न तपाईँ राम्रोसँग जवाब दिनुहोस् भन्ने म चाहन्छु शान्ति र संविधान आजको हाम्रो आवश्यकता हो शान्ति र संविधान आजको हाम्रो आवश्यकता हो तर संविधान निर्माण पहिले कि संविधान निर्माण पहिले कि शान्ति स्थापनाको प्राथमिकता कुन पहिले हुनुपर्छ म अङ्ग्रेजीमा पनि भनौँ पिस And constitution, both are today's necessity of our country. Okay? In your opinion, establishment of peace or formulation of a new constitution should be given more priority and why?
In my opinion, peace should be given more priority. Because even if the constitution is maintained, if there is no peace, there is no confidence or like the state can't guarantee that the constitution whatever is made will last so I think peace should be maintained thank you
so let's hope that impressed our judges and now we would like to welcome our next semi-finalist please pick a judge And she has chosen Mr. Prakash Sayami.
Hello, Samyukta.
Hello, sir. How are you?
तपाईंले क्वेशन सोध्नु भन्दा अगाडि मै नर्भस भइरहेछ। तपाईंलाई हाम्रा फोटोग्राफरले सुन्दर फोटो खिच्नु भन्दा अगाडि तपाईं आज एकदम सुन्दर देख्नु भएको छ। बधाई छ।
Thank you.
हाम्रो चिफ जज चान्दनी जोशी लगायत हामी 10 जना जजको तपाईँ यहाँ सेमी फाइनलिस्टमा चुनिनु भएकोमा हार्दिक बधाई छ
थ्याङ्क यू अगेन सर
विश्वको यो नयाँ गणतान्त्रिक मुलुकमा यत्रो विरोधका बावजुद पनि तपाईँहरू यस्तो सहभागिता जनाउनु भएकोमा पनि फेरि बधाई छ
थ्याङ्क यू अगेन
मेरो प्रश्न अत्यन्त हलुका छ तर भित्र हृदयबाट गम्भीर भएर सोधिदिनु सुनिदिनु होला यदि तपाईँको जीवनमा तपाईँको विवाह तपाईँको अध्ययन पुरा नहुँदै तपाईँको अभिभावकले निर्णय गरिदिए भने तपाईँ त्यो स्थितिलाई कसरी सम्हाल्नुहुन्छ अब उत्तर भन्नलाई अङ्ग्रेजी पनि सोधौँ होला होइन समय पाउनुहुन्छ इफ युर प्यारेन्ट्स फिक्स युर म्यारेज बिफोर द कम्प्लिसन अफ युर स्टडिज हाउ विल यु डिल विथ द सिचुएसन
If my parents fixed my marriage before I completed my studies, I would revolt against it and I would firstly talk to my parents and explain them the importance of education for a 21st century woman. A woman cannot stand anywhere in the world without formal education. So firstly, I would convince my parents till my death probably to let me study and let me complete my education and then after that, whatever they have in store for me, I'll agree to that. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Well, that was very impressive there. Now, please welcome our next semi-finalist. You need to pick your judge as well.